Do you know that the reptiles dominated our planet for a long time? Animals of class Reptilia first appeared in late Paleozoic and they became numerous by Mesozoic. This is known as the Age of Reptiles. These are the first vertebrates completely adapted for life on land, though a few have become secondarily aquatic. We will study the characters and position of Reptilia by studying the classification of the living reptiles in the first part on reptiles. They are distinguished by the characters like reptiles are ectothermal, sometimes called helioderms, terrestrial or aquatic tetrapoda. Generally, they have an exoskeleton of dry epidermal scales, bony plates or scutes. Endoskeleton is more completely bony than amphibians. The skull has one occipital condyle. Vertebral column is differentiated into regions. Vertebrae are gastrocentrous, and in living forms, two vertebrae form a sacrum. Iliosacral articulation is post-acetabular. The limbs are short, pentadactyle, and ending in horny claws. The locomotion is generally by creeping, hence they are called reptilia. Lungs are the sole respiratory organs, except in some aquatic caenulia, in which cloaca is respiratory. The heart is imperfectly four-chambered, showing two auricles and incompletely divided ventricle, or totally divided in crocodilians. Kidneys are metanephric with no nephrostomes and are associated with water conservation. The excretory waste is mostly uric acid. There are 12 pairs of cranial nerves. There is cloaca, which is often complicated. Fertilization is internal because male has single or double penis as external copulatory organs. The egg is provided with two characteristic membranes called amnion and allantois. The amnion serves as a private aquarium to prevent the egg from desiccation, and allantois serves as embryonic respiratory and excretory organ. A yolk sac provides nourishment. Reptiles are the first true vertebrates because the cladoic, that is, closed or self-contained egg, which is laid and develops on land. Even aquatic reptiles come on land to lay eggs. No metamorphosis is seen. Now let's see the position of reptiles in the animal classification. Kingdom, Eukaryota. Subkingdom, Metazoa. Division, Eumetazoa. Phylum, Chordata. Subphylum, Vertebrata. Group, Gnathostomata. Superclass, Tetrapoda. Clade, Amniota. Class, Reptilia. Laurenti stated 1768 subgroups. Class Reptilia is further classified into 6 subclasses: Enepsida, Cynaptosauria, Ichthyopterygia, Lapidosauria, Archosauria, Cynapsida. Enepsida, Lapidosauria and Archosauria consist of living reptiles. Other 3 are extinct. We will talk more about them in the second program on reptiles. Reptilia is a diverse group of vertebrates that includes creatures such as snakes, amphisbaenians, lizards, alligators, caimans, crocodiles, tortoises, turtles, and tuataras. There are approximately 7,900 species of reptiles alive today that inhabit a wide range of temperate and tropical habitats, including deserts, forests, freshwater, wetlands, mangroves, and open ocean. Reptiles are cold-blooded vertebrates, which, unlike amphibians, possess thick, impermeable skin covered by scales. The reptilian skeleton differs from other vertebrates in various ways. For example, mammals have a single lower jawbone called the mandible, but reptiles have several bones in their lower jaw that enable them with greater bite mobility. Also, they have only one bone in each ear, the stapes, whereas mammals have three small bones in each ear, the malleus, incus, and stapes. Reptiles also have only one occipital condyle, a protrusion on the skull that forms a joint that enables movement of the head, while mammals and amphibians have two occipital condyles. They have lungs, not gills, and usually a three-chambered heart, except for crocodilians, whose hearts have four chambers. Their eggs are covered with watertight shells. Thus, they have severed the amphibians' link to water and fully conquered land. Described living species are 7,131. Subclass 1. Anapsida, meaning no opening. It has solid roof of the skull, no temporal vacuity or fossae in the skull. Quadrate is connected to the optic bones. Limbs are generally strong. Body is enclosed in the carapace and plastron. Order 1. Chelonia. Permian to recent. Turtles are distinguished by their large shells, which consist of an outer carapace and a breast covering plastron. They live throughout the world, in the ocean, in fresh water, and on land, in which case they are called tortoises. Some turtles are believed to live for more than 150 years. Only distantly related to other living reptiles, turtles have changed little in last 300 million years. Described living species are 260. We can describe them as: they are terrestrial or aquatic, Tetrapoda pentadactyle with walking limbs or paddles. Trunk is enclosed in a bony shell dorsal carapace and ventral plastron, which may or may not be covered with horny shield. Tail is always present. Jaws covered with horny epidermal plates, no teeth. Quadrate bone is fixed. Thoracic vertebrae and ribs modified along with epidermal plates, usually fused to form the shell. Two sacral vertebrae, ribs with capitular portion only, girdles inside the ribs, humerus with anti-epicondylar foramen, pubis and ischia form symphysis. Copulatory organ is unpaired. Cloacal opening is longitudinal. Oviparous. Little change since Triassic, and are the oldest living reptile in the world. Examples: Chelus, Amis, Chelonia, Testudo. Subclass 2. Lapidosauria, scaly lizards. The main feature of the period of reptilian dominance, the diapsid skull, is found in these animals and which is present in all living reptiles except the Chelonia and in the birds. Lapidosauria, which includes Spinodon, the lizards and snakes, they show the characteristics like two temporal vacuities are present, anterior orbital vacuities are absent, post-temporal fenestrae are usually present, humerus with two foramina. Order 1. Rhynchocephalia, Triassic to recent. Only two species remain of this ancient line of lizards like reptiles, which now live only in certain parts of New Zealand. They possess the presence of two vacuities, teeth acrodont, an epipterygoid is present, quadrate bone is fixed or immovable, parietal foramen is present, vertebrae emphysellus, external copulatory organs are entirely absent. Example, Sphenodon. Order 2, Squamata, Triassic to recent. Body covered with horny epidermal scales, single temporal vacuity in lizards and no temporal vacuity in snakes. Skull has lost one or both temporal regions. Teeth set in sockets, pleurodont. Quadrate is movable. Vertebrae are usually procellous. Abdominal ribs usually greatly reduced or absent. Limbs present or absent. Cloacal opening transverse. Male possesses a pair of eversible copulatory organs. Contains most modern reptiles. There are three groups of reptiles evolved comparatively recently, means in the Jurassic period, so that even today they share certain anatomical similarities and are all put in the same order. Examples, snakes, lizards, and amphisbaenians. Described living species are 6,847. Suborder 1, Lesotelia, Triassic to recent. The most successful of all the reptiles, lizards, represent about 54% of reptilian species. Extremely diverse as well, lizards live on every continent except Antarctica and in nearly every conceivable habitat from deserts to tundras, mountains to oceans. Terrestrial, arboreal or burrowing forms have slender body. Single, supra or upper temporal vacuity is present. Limbs are usually present, tetrapoda and pentadactyle. The rami of mandibles are fused in front. Sternum present, eyelids movable, tympanum present. Familiar examples include chameleons, iguanas, geckos, skinks, monitor lizards, and many more. Infraorder 1, Geckota, mainly recent. Examples, gecko, pygopus, hemidactylus, tychozoans. Infraorder 2, iguania, Cretaceous to recent. Examples, iguana, annulus, phrynosoma, draco, lyrocephalus, agama, camellia, amblyrhynchus, calotis. Infraorder 3, Syncomorpha, Eocene to recent. Examples, Lacerta, Syncus. Infraorder 4, Anguimorpha, Cretaceous to recent. Examples, Varanus, Anguis. Suborder 2, Ophidia, Cretaceous to recent. Snakes. Of all the tetrapods that have lost their limbs, snakes are by far the most successful. They are exclusively carnivorous and often fearsome predators. Their muscles have adapted for swift movement. Their digestive systems allow them to swallow the whole prey. And their bodies have adapted to an extremely wide range of environments. They live on every continent except Antarctica. Described living species are 2,647. Terrestrial or aquatic, arboreal or burrowing. Temporal vacuities are entirely absent. Limbs absent. The rami of mandibles are united by a ligament. Sternum absent. Eyelids immovable. Tympanum absent. Tongue is bifid or protrusible. Zygosphene and zygantra are present in the vertebra. Examples: python, natrix, naja, vipera. Suborder 3: amphisbaenia or worm lizards. Recent. They are unique. Not only are they limbless like snakes, they are also among living reptiles the only specialized burrowers and live exclusively underground. They inhabit in South America, Africa, Spain, and the Middle East. Described living species are 133. Example: amphisbaena. Subclass 3: archosauria, the ruling reptiles, including the crocodiles, dinosaurs, pterosaurs, that is, flying lizards, and ancestors of birds. They were the dominant land animals during Mesozoic. Crocodiles are the only descendants of this group. The birds, which are also undoubtedly descendants of this group, give us in some ways a better idea of characteristic structure. Skull with closed upper temporal vacuity, but possesses both temporal arches, means diapsid skull. Anterior orbital vacuities are usually present. Teeth are thicodont. Humerus with foramina. Vertebrae are amphiphilus or prosilus. Some lions had the tendency to walk on the hind legs like dinosaurs and pterosaurs, where the hind legs were much longer. Order 1: Crocodilia, Triassic to recent. They are freshwater or predatory forms. Body is covered with an exoskeleton of thick horny epidermal scales. Bony plates embedded in epidermis. Tail is long and laterally compressed. Maxillae, palatines and pterygoids are united along the middle to form a secondary palate. Teeth set in sockets, thicodont. Quadrate, immovable, fixed. Both supra and infra arches are present. Vertebrae, prosilous. Sternum is present. Cervical vertebrae with two-headed ribs. Thoracic ribs possess uncinate process. Abdominal ribs present in gastrilia. Prepubis present. Pubis does not share in the formation of acetabulum. Heart is four-chambered and ventricles completely separated in two septum. Lungs are spongy. Cloacal opening longitudinal. Crop similar to birds. Examples: Crocodilus, Alligator, Caiman, Gavialis. Poisonous snakes of India. There are about 300 varieties of snakes, out of which only 30 are poisonous. Before knowing about poisonous and non-poisonous snakes, let's have some awareness of the primary treatment on the snake bite. Ayurveda, the basic Indian medication applied since centuries, suggests many solutions to face the problems of different types of snake bites. Wherever the snake bites, first of all, tie up that organ tightly from a distance of 4 inches to the bite towards the heart side, due to which the poison will not spread all over the body. The neem tree, Asa directa indica, a plant of Indian origin, is very useful for more than 30 diseases. Here is a simple process to be followed to cure a snake bite. The patient has to eat leaves of a neem tree. If poison has been mixed into the blood, the bitter taste will not be felt. The permanent solution for safety, one has to eat a few leaves of the neem tree daily, which will give permanent immunity from the snake poison. The paste of the leaves of neem is also effective to neutralize the effect of snake poison. This paste can be used orally and applied locally as well. Give the paste of the roots of Kariza, Karamdi, orally with water to the patient of snake bite and watch. If the patient doesn't start vomiting, it shows that the poison has been mixed in the blood. And if he starts vomiting, it means he's out of danger. The soapy water of Sapindus trifoliate, Rita plant. Foam is to be applied in the eyes of the patient. If the eyes start burning, it shows that there is no poisonous effect. But if it's there, go on applying the water to the eyes. Whenever the effect of poison is neutralized, the patient will start complaining about burning sensation. A polyvalent serum that effectively neutralizes the venom of all the big four snakes is widely available in India and is frequently used to save lives. Remember that mostly people die due to fear of snake bite and not by the poison of it. Key to identify poisonous or non-poisonous snakes. Sea snake. Tail laterally compressed. Head scales large. Russell's viper. Belly scales broad. Triangular head. Thick trunk and short tail. 3 rows of diamond-shaped marks on back. Pitless viper. Belly scales broad, white, arrow-shaped mark on head, head scales small, scales below tail entire, that is subdivided. Pit viper, belly scales broad, head scales large, tip-tailed nose, a pit between nostril and eye. Crate, belly scales broad, mid dorsal scales large, fourth lower labial largest, scales below tail entire. Cobra, belly scales broad, head scales large, expanded hood marked by V, third labial touching eye and nostril. Indian cobra, Naja Naja, probably the most famous of all Indian snakes. Common crate and Russell's viper are the 4 venomous snake species responsible for causing the most snake bite cases in South Asia, mostly in India. Whenever you see the snake, try to identify and never be panic. If the snake is very near, don't move till it passes. But if you try to harm the snake, it may harm you.